to hop on this call. Matter of fact, take a screenshot of this call and send it in all of the chats. We need it packed out, family. For all new family that just joined the call, check this out. This is what I want you to do. I want you to take a screenshot of this Zoom call and post it and flood it in all the chats that you're in. Make sure everybody hops on this call. Make sure that everybody hops on this call. Hey, check this out. The time is now 3 p.m. I will be starting the call at 3:05. Hey, let's continue to keep spamming the chats, family. Yo, family, we got about 2 more minutes. We got about 2 more minutes before I start the training. Make sure you get as many people on this call as possible. I want to say we're at 173. Hey, man, check this out. Let's see if we can get it to 200 before 305. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Yo, family, what's going on? Check this out, my name is Jordan Farmer. I'm one of the newest Platinum 5000s in Dignified Drip. And hey man, I'm happy to be on the training today. Real quick. From a scale of 1 to 10, how is everybody doing today? From a scale of 1 to 10? Let me know. How is everybody doing today? Hey man, shout out to Duke man for the new drip. Please go cop your DD drip ASAP. See a few 10s, I see a few 8s, 7s, cool. Well, hopefully after this call, I can get you back up to a 10. Now check this out. Before I actually get into the training, I wanna touch on a few topics. As you know, DD is in momentum right now. Now what exactly does that mean? That means that GV is skyrocketing. So when GV is going up, that means that there's more people enrolling into your business every single day, right? So when there's a lot of people coming into your business, you need to be able to accommodate the new customers that's coming into your business. Now check this out. Let's talk about the 5 pillars of success, right? We have education, we have prospects, we have education, we have results, we have prospects, we have individual trainings, and we have calling your team. So I want you to understand that number one, education, and number four individual trainings heavily correlate because you must be educated to be able to teach somebody else. Now, as a mentor, our duty is to transfer information. And one of the ways that we transfer information is by teaching. So for the people that's on this call, for the people that understand how to use the simple scalper, even if you do know how to use it, stay on this training to learn how to teach, because this will help you skyrocket your business. The more trainers, the more product training that you will be able to do, the more people that you will be able to maintain in your business. Because individual trainers is all about molding the people in your back office, right? Because at the end of the day, we market that we can show you how to multiply your money in the world's largest market, right? So please take this training very, 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 very serious. Again, my name is Jordan Farmer, and I'm the newest Platinum 5000 in the business. So check this out. I'm not gonna hold y'all too long. I kind of want to get straight into the training. So I'm gonna share my screen, but before I share my screen, drop a 2 in the chat if you have a notepad and pencil. Let me know. Drop a 2 in the chat if you have a notepad and pencil. Cool. Let me actually go. Now, today, this is everything that I will be going over. I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna be on these trainers a lot. And when you get to know me, you're gonna realize that I go to Google Docs for everything. Everything that I do strategically in my business, every strategy, every system, I got it all in my Google Docs. It's the perfect way to learn how to backtrack your success so you can always go back to figure out what you did here. So check this out. Simple scalper training. Number one, we're going to do a whole entire breakdown of indicators. I realize that a lot of people try to use the products and they don't necessarily know what the indicators mean or how to actually use it, right? Number two, how price moves inside of the Bollinger Band is very important. Number three, the difference between a bullish and bearish candle, because a lot of people don't know the difference, right? How these candles react. How the candles react to different zones or to zones. Let me edit that real quick. How do candles react to zones? Number five, how to identify a buying or selling opportunity, and how to find a proper entry, right? So hopefully you can get everything that you need from this training to help you be as profitable as possible. Now, let's actually get into the breakdown of the indicators. Now check this out, family. This will be a very extensive training, right? So I'm not gonna lie, get relaxed. If you got a bottle of water, if you got a drink, you might wanna have it right beside you, because I'm gonna give you the whole entire spiel of this simple scalper. Yes, and this training is recorded. It's being recorded right now. Now, the indicators. Now, the first indicator that I wanna talk about is the 200 EMA. Now, what exactly does the 200 EMA look like? Let me zoom out a little bit. Let me make the screen a little bit bigger, right? Now this purple line right here, a lot of people turn it black. I'm gonna make it black so you can see it a little bit better. Or really, we can just keep it like this, it's okay. This purple line that's going through the market, through price, is a 200 EMA, right? You can write that down. This purple line is a 200 EMA. Now I'm teaching a regular simple scalper. And honestly, I would choose the regular simple scalper over a simple scalper 2.0, because the RSI and the stochastic, they will show you moves before 2.0 weeks. I think the 2.0 uses a histogram and an oscillator, if I'm not mistaken. Histogram and an oscillator. So the RSI and the stochastic will definitely give you better entries. All right, so check this out. The 200 EMA is this purple line right here. So let's actually dive into what the 200 EMA is. Now, check this out. 200 EMA is a very popular indicator that is used to determine the main underlying trend. This indicator allows a trader to determine the trend in respect of any corrective move in the price action, right? Now, what do you need to know about the 200 EMA? When the price is below the 200 EMA, you have a downtrend. If the EMA slopes down, the trend is stronger. When the price is above the 200 EMA, this is an uptrend. If the EMA slopes upward, the trend is strongly bullish. Check this out. If you don't have enough time to get these notes, please take a screenshot. Please take a screenshot. All right. Now, let's go. Let me refer back to the chart. Now, as you realize, or if you see, whenever the 200 EMA is above price, price is in a current downtrend. You have a lot of highs. You have a lot of lower lows. You got a lot of lower highs and you got a lot of lower lows, right? Be conscious of this. Now, check this out. whenever price actually breaks through, let me find an example. Gotta go all the way down here. Bear with me. Now check this out. Whenever price is on the bottom, or whenever the 200 EMA is on the bottom, you will realize that the market will always be in an uptrend. See what happens when the 200 EMA actually crosses through? Boom, it's a total change of structure, right? It's no longer in an uptrend. You can see the cross happen right here. Cross happened right here. And as you can see, the market is continuing up. The market is continuing up. A quick fact, the 200 EMA can be used as support and resistance if it doesn't break through structure. For example, price actually pulled back to the 200 EMA. It didn't break through and it continued in an uptrend. For example, we're gonna put this right here. And price continued to go up. Price continued to go up, right? Let me find another example for you. For example, right? The market is now selling. Price actually pulled back to the 200 EMA. It didn't necessarily break through, but as you can see, it corrected and continued to go in a downtrend. I'm not gonna lie, if you have family that's not on this call, I definitely advise you to get them on this call ASAP. Honest to truth. Now, drop a one in the chat if you understand the 200 EMA. It shows trend, family, it shows trend. Let me see some tools in the chat. Okay, cool. Now, let's move on to the next indicator. The next indicator would be the parabolic SAR. Now, the parabolic SAR attempts to give traders an edge by highlighting the direction an asset is moving in, as well as providing entry and exit points. The parabolic SAR indicator developed by J. Willis Wilder Jr. is used by traders to determine trend direction and potential reversals in price. Now, with my experience of using parabolic SARs, it's better used with traditional Forex. With traditional Forex, if you're a scalper, then it basically gives you a trailing stop and it shows you the reversal of the market. So you can go ahead and hop out your trades before you blow your account, right? Now, let me actually show it to you on the charts right here. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you. When it comes to HFX, everything moves pretty fast. Let me zoom in real quick. Everything moves pretty fast. So I'm not gonna lie to you, when you're using the parabolic SARs with HFX, they are just momentum-based indicators. They're basically telling you where the market is headed and where the market is going. That's all you really need to know. It's basically telling you where the market is headed and where the market is going. Okay, now check this out. Let me move to the next indicator. Pretty simple. And for those of you who didn't get a screenshot of the parabolic SAR, please screenshot it. And I'm not gonna lie, after this training, I will be releasing a video on my YouTube page and I will be dropping these notes in a dignified drip family chat. All right. Now, volume bars. Now, there's a bigger definition of volume bars, but I don't want to necessarily confuse anybody. So check this out. Volume bars indicates if the market has buying or selling momentum. That's honestly all you need to know. Now, what does a volume bar look like? These are volume bars. As you notice, check this out. Let me go get my horizontal line. As you see, I'm gonna make it a little bit blacker. So check this out. Now look, as you can see, the volume bar is blue. Bullish candle. The volume bar is red. Bearish candle. Now let's move on to the next indicator. Now, relative strength index. Now please pay attention, AKA RSI. The relative strength index is most commonly used to indicate temporarily overbought or oversold conditions in a market.
An intraday forex trading strategy can be devised to take advantage of indicators from the RSI that a market is overextended and therefore likely to retrace. The RSI is a widely used technical indicator and an oscillator that indicates a market is overbought when the RSI value is over 70 and indicates oversold with conditions when RSI readings are under 30. Some traders and analysts prefer to use the more extreme readings of 80 and 20, but check this out. We're going to stick to the 70-30. A weakness of the RSI, hey, pay attention. A weakness of the RSI is that a sudden sharp price movements can cause it to spike repeatedly up or down, and thus it is prone to giving false signals. However, if those spikes or falls show a trading confirmation when compared with other signals, it could signal an entry or exit point. Now, with this one, I gave you the pros and I gave you the cons. Now, I want you to understand that we can only predict the market a certain percentage. We can't predict the market 100%, right? But helping using all of the indicators together will increase our percentage in the market, right? That's why you just don't go strictly off the RSI. You have to use the RSI, the stochastic, the Bollinger Bands, everything that comes with the product, right? It will definitely increase your percentage. Now, let me actually show you the RSI. Double click. And the RSI is right here, the relative strength index. Right now it's 75-25. I'm going to change it to 70-30, right? And I'm going to make these lines solid. Make the upper line solid, and I'm going to make the bottom line solid. Cool. Now, check this out. This is the 70, this is the 30. Now, anything that's overbought, if anything above the 70 in this area, right? Now, anything oversold is anything below the 30 in this area. Drop a 5 in the chat if you understand the RSI. Let me know. Blow the chat up. If you understand RSI, the relative strength index, please drop a 5 in the chat. Gotcha. Now, check this out. Let's move into the Bollinger Bands, right? Then after that, we have a stochastic oscillator. Matter of fact, let's talk about the stochastic first since it's a little bit closer. It is a momentum indicator comparing a particular closing price of the security to a range of its prices over a certain period of time. The sensitivity of the oscillator to market movements is reducible by adjusting that time period or by taking a moving average of the result. It is used to generate overbought and oversold trading signals. That's the second time that I've seen overbought and oversold. Take notes, family, take notes. Now, what does the stochastic oscillator, I can't even pronounce it. What does the stochastic oscillator tell you? The stochastic oscillator is range bound, meaning it is always between 0 and 100. This makes it a useful indicator of overbought and oversold conditions. It's the third time we heard that, right? Traditionally, reading over 80 are considered in the overbought range and readings under 20 are considered oversold. However, these are not always indicative of impending reversal. Very strong trends can maintain overbought or oversold conditions for an extended period of time. Instead, traders should look to changes in the stochastic oscillator for clues in future trend shift. So at the end of the day, if you're solely just depending on the stochastic oscillator, your percentage will be very low in the market. But check this out. How about we combine the both? How about we combine the two, the stochastic and the relative strength index? It's increasing our percentage. Now, what exactly does the stochastic look like? It's this bottom line right here. The upper line, which is the red line, will consist of 80, and this bottom line will consist of 20. Now, check this out. I'm going to change this line to a solid line. I'm going to change the bottom line to a solid line. Now, let's get into it. Anything above the 80 is overbought. Anything below the 20 is oversold. Drop a 3 in the chat if you understand the stochastic oscillator. Check this out. If you know me, I'm going to make sure that my audience is very attentive on making sure everybody is paying attention. Let me see some 3s in the chat. Let me go look at the chat. 271 on the call. That's cool. Now, for those of you who didn't get it, let me repeat. This is the stochastic oscillator, right? Now, anything above the 80 is overbought, and anything below the 20, which is right here, this bottom line right here, is oversold. Now, let's get into the most important indicator. Shout out to Rock. This is his favorite indicator. The Bollinger Bands. The Bollinger Bands, check this out. Bollinger Bands are a form of technical analysis that traders use to plot trend lines that are two standard deviations away from simple moving average price of a security. The goal is to help a trader know when to enter or exit a position by identifying when an asset has been overbought or oversold. That's crazy. The Bollinger Bands, the RSI, and the stochastic are all telling you about overbought and oversold conditions. Now everybody can see the correlation on why these indicators are in this product. We have to use them together in order to get the highest percentage in a trade. Now, Bollinger Bands were designed by John Bollinger. Bollinger Bands help by signaling changes in volatility. For generally steady ranges of a security such as many currency pairs, Bollinger Bands act as relatively clear signals for buying and selling. This can result in stopouts and frustrating losses, though, so traders consider other factors when placing trades in relation to Bollinger Bands. So if you understand the Bollinger Bands, you can trade with just Bollinger Bands, but it's better to trade with all of the indicators together. All right. Now, that's it for the indicators. Hopefully everybody took a screenshot. Let's get back to our what we got going on. Now, number two, how price moves inside of the Bollinger Band. This is very important, right? Because this is actually where you will find your entry at. Let me go to the Liberty. Let me go to Liberty. And I'm going to do this. Y'all probably never seen this before, but I usually do this all the time. Now, check this out. This is my higher Bollinger. This is my middle Bollinger. And this will be my lower Bollinger, right? Now, check this out. This arrow that I'm about to use is price. So check this out. When price comes into the Bollinger Band, I want you to understand that the price will always stay in between these Bollinger Bands, right? The Bollinger Band may adjust to accommodate price, but it will always stay in between these Bollinger Bands. So check this out. If price comes to the red, right? We want to think sell. And I'm gonna add a background to it. I'm gonna put black. We wanna think sell. Let me make this a little bit smaller. We wanna think sell, right? Boom. Now, you wanna think of the Bollinger Band sometimes as support and resistance. When price gets to a resistance, you can expect sell if it doesn't break through. And when price gets back down to the blue family, what are we expecting price to do now? Drop it in the chat box. What are we expecting price to do right now? Most definitely. Check this out. When it comes back down to the blue and it pierces the blue, we think buy. Cool. Now, say that price gets here and it doesn't break through. What can we expect? We can expect a sell to retest the blue Bollinger Band. We can expect a reversal, right? can expect a sale, right? If it doesn't break through, sometimes you may see a candle come and reject off this middle Bollinger Band, right? And it might not be able to break through the middle Bollinger Band, so you can expect price to come all the way back down to test the lower bunch, right? And we already know when price gets here, we're expecting to buy. So I'm not even gonna draw that up. I'm gonna take this all the way up here. We know when price gets to the red Bollinger Band, cool. We're expecting to sell. But check this out. What if price comes here and it doesn't break through? What are we expecting, family? Drop it in the chat box. Drop it in the chat box. What are we expecting right now? What are we expecting right now? A buy, most definitely, most definitely, most definitely, most definitely. Boom. We're expecting a buy, right? Drop a one in the chat, family, if you understand how price moves inside of these Bollinger Bands. Cool, 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 cool. I'm seeing the chat's getting flooded. That means everybody's paying attention. Now, let's go to number three. Now, in order to actually indicate your entry, you need to understand the difference between a bullish candle and a bearish candle as well. So I can break that down. I can break that down to you. Let me delete everything. So boom. Then we have boom. We'll make this candle red. Now check this out. I'm not gonna lie to you. A lot of people may be like, oh yeah, the blue candle is the bullish candle and the red candle is the bearish candle. But check this out, that doesn't necessarily mean anything, right? Because you can edit the colors of your candles. This is how you can be able to tell the difference between a bullish and bearish candle. Now, let me label this real quick. Got a bullish candle. Got a bullish candle. And we have a bearish candle. And we have a bearish candle. Now, check this out. A bullish candle will open at the bottom, buy all the way to the top, and close at the top. Now check this out. We're on a 5-minute time frame right now. A candlestick is a measurement of time, right? Now, each candlestick is a measurement of time, right? Now, what this means is that each candlestick that does pop up is worth 5 minutes. So it takes 5 minutes for this candle to open at the bottom and close at the top. Now, bearish candle. A bearish candle will open at the top and sail all the way down to close at the bottom. Drop a 3 in the chat if you understand the difference between a bullish and bearish candle. Let me know. All right, cool. Cool. Now, how do candles react to zones? So let's actually talk about this, and I'm gonna go over this pretty quick. So I'm gonna use support and resistance, for example. Now, I have my resistance, which is up here. And I have my support, which is down here. As we know, support will always be the floor and resistance will always be the ceiling, right? So check this out. Say that we have a bullish candle. Let's say that we have a barrage of bullish candles, right? Yeah, boom. Yeah, boom. And we have boom. Now check this out. Say that price comes all the way out here, right? But it can't push through the resistance. So what happens? The sellers will then push price back down. And then a lot of times, I'm gonna make this a little bigger than it's supposed to be because it won't let me do it the regular way. So a lot of times, what will happen is price will push up all the way up here and they come back down, right? Now drop a two in the chat if you've ever seen something like this. You ever seen something like this, drop a two in the chat. This is called a rejection. This is called a rejection of a zone, right? Now, let's actually, let's do it the opposite way. Let's do it the opposite way. Let's do it the opposite way. Now, check this out. Let me change this to red. Let me change this to red. And say that price actually, hold on real quick. Say that price actually pushes down past support, but it can't break past support. So the buyers actually push the market back up. This is called a rejection of the support level. Everybody should have seen this before, right? And I'm not gonna lie to you, this is very important because this will show you how to read price when it gets to certain Bollinger Bands or certain zones, all right? Drop a five in the chat if you understand the reaction to different zones. Going down my list, family, I'm going down my list. And it's crazy because the people that got off this call, they're going, you know. And by the way, this is actually recorded. This will actually be going on my YouTube page right after this. So I will actually send the link to this training right after. All right. Cool. Now, next. Okay, so we understand 1 through 4. Now let's get into number 5. So what I'm going to do is actually redraw my Bollinger Bands because those are very important. I have my higher Bollinger. I have my middle Bollinger. All right, it's kind of ugly, but it's all good. And then I have my lower Bollinger, right? Now, let me go back here. And I actually have my confirmations on here as well. Let me see if I can find it. All right, so let's look for a bearish confirmation. So check this out. A bearish candle must pierce the blue Bollinger Band, must be rejected off Bollinger Band, or opposite candle must be opening up and closed before entry. All right. Let me read that one more time. Number one, a bearish candle must pierce the blue Bollinger Band, must be rejecting off Bollinger Band or piercing the Bollinger Band. The opposite candle must open and close before entry. So let's actually take a look at what that actually looks like. Now, usually when we're looking for a buying opportunity, it's going to be coming from the higher Bollinger Band, right? So you're going to get a barrage or a group of... We're going to get a group, hold on, let me change the color of this Bollinger real quick. So you're going to get a group of bearish candles. As you know, a bearish candle opens at the top and closes at the bottom, right? Going to get a group of bearish candles, and I'm going to try to make this as realistic as possible, family. Please bear with me. May have one bullish candle in there, right? You may have a bearish candle. You may have a bearish candle. Then you may have a bullish candle. Right? And then you got that one bearish candle that just pierces the blue Bollinger Band. So this is exactly what we're looking for, family. That's exactly what we're looking for. That's one half of the confirmation. But check this out. Let's go back. Now, The opposite candle must open and close before entry. Now look, this is where the entry is gonna come from. We have to get the opposite candle. To open on this blue Bollinger Band. And boom. This is our buying entry. And where will we enter the market at? We will enter the market at the end of this bullish candle or buy. All right. Because we expect price to continue to go up. Right? Drop a three in the chat if that makes sense. Drop a three in the chat if that makes sense. Like I said, you must get a bearish candle piercing the blue Bollinger Band and the opposite candle opening up and closing. Right, and the entry will be at the end of this bullish candle. That's for a buying opportunity. Now, check this out. Let's actually look at a selling opportunity real quick. Now, usually with a sell, you'll get a group of bullish candles. Group of bullish candles, like I said, I'm gonna make it as realistic as possible. Boom, one bullish candle. Hold on. You might get one bearish candle. And you might just get a collective bullish candle, all right? Let's just say we get that one last bullish candle that pierces the red Bollinger Band. Now, let's go look at the confirmations. Number one, a bullish candle must pierce the red Bollinger Band, must be rejecting off Bollinger Band or piercing the Bollinger Band. Opposite candle must open and close before entry. So we got one half. All right, we have one half. Now check this out. This is what we're looking for. We're looking for price to open, bearish, and close. So this is what we're looking for right now. And our entry will be after the close of this candle. Drop a two in the chat if you understand the selling opportunity. Now, this is very important. A lot of people may be like, dang, like, okay, cool. How do I find a buying and selling opportunity? The Bollinger Band is how you find your selling and buying opportunity, right? If you can find confirmation number one, you can now go down the list to find everything else. Like I said, drop something in the chat if you understand this, if this makes sense. So Sam, you said, so what if the wicks, the Bollinger Band, and then closes? So basically, are you talking about this candle? Yeah, that's still a rejection. That's still a rejection or pierce. A rejection will have a wick and a pierce would look like this. That answers your question. All right, so let's actually get into the charts now. So I can show you everything in real time. So now, how to find the proper entry. Cool. And this will be pretty easy. So let me actually go back in the past because I like to back test a lot and I find a lot of good entries back in the past, right? Matter of fact, this may be a great one right here. Cool, this is a good one. Now check this out. Listen, family, listen. Let me go to my confirmations. And what I like to do is I like to have my confirmations on the screen so I can honestly follow my confirmations. I can follow all of my confirmations. Let me copy it. Let me go to Liberty. Now check this out. Now for my buying confirmations. A bearish candle must pierce the blue Bollinger Band, must be rejecting off Bollinger Band. Opposite candle must open and close before entry. Now check this out. This candle right here actually pierced the blue Bollinger Band, but we didn't get the other half of the confirmation, so we wouldn't have hopped in that trade or looked for any other confirmation. But check this out. This candle right here actually pierced this blue Bollinger Band, and you see the opposite candle opening up, right? It opened up right here. So that's one confirmation. That is one confirmation. Boom. Now, the volume bar must be blue. Now, the volume bar must be blue because this bullish candle opened up like it was supposed to. And like I say, the volume bar showed buying momentum. Cool. That's our second confirmation. Now, it says the stochastic has to be oversold, but I want to say the RSI definitely comes before the stochastic. So check this out. Look at number four. RSI has to be oversold and crossing up on the 30. So check this out, family. The RSI is right here, and we're right here. Cool. I'm going to drag my horizontal line down, and if I actually take these to the right a little bit. Boom. Anything below the 30 is oversold. Anything below the 30 is oversold. So this is what we're looking for. We're looking for this line to cross up on the 30. So it should be doing one of these. Boom. That's an indicator, right? That's an indication. Boom. Now, the stochastic has to be oversold and crossing up on the 20. Cool. Let's go to the stochastic. Stochastic is right here. Hold on. Let me make sure I put a vertical line just to see what's going on. The stochastic is right here. And price has to be oversold below the 20. Now, like I said, the bottom line is a 20. And what are we looking at? We're looking for a price to cross up on the 20. Now we have all of our indicators. Now check this out. Let's actually go look for the currency strength unit real quick. Now listen, I'm looking for a bot. So I have my primary currency, which is the GBP, the Great British Pound, and I have my secondary currency, which is the US dollar, right? So if I'm looking for a buy, I'm expecting GBP to have way more bars than the US dollar. In this case, it's happening right now. So this would be basically a 5-point trade. We have all five confirmations. And now the only thing that we're waiting for is the close of this candle, right? Now,
yes.
I have all five confirmations and we're waiting for the close of this candle. Let me actually delete this real quick.
What's up, man?
Hold on.
What do you need?
All right. Boom. That'll be our entry. All right. So when it closes, all right, we are looking for a 15-minute trade. Now, we're on a 5-minute time frame. So each candlestick is worth 5 minutes. So we're in this trade for a span of 15 minutes. So that would be 5, 10, 15. Let me go to a line chart to see you so I can show you. Right. If we enter right here, did we win the trade or did we lose the trade? Let me know. Did we win the trade or did we lose the trade? Did we win this trade or did we lose the trade? We won, right? And I'm not gonna lie to you. A lot of people may hop in with 3-minute trades, but I'm not gonna lie. Our time for stronger confirmations, right? higher time frames have stronger confirmation. So I would prefer a 15-minute trade if you want the most wins. All right. Remember our entries right here. We clear, right? Some people clear for $5. Some people clear for $10. Some people clear for $100. Hey, use proper risk management. Now let's go over selling opportunity, and that will be, so that will be it. Let me change this back to candles, and let me find a pretty good selling opportunity. Remember how I said the 200 EMA can be used as support and resistance as well. Price is coming up here and rejecting off of it, and boom, shooting back down, right? And I'm not gonna lie, if you have an overbought market or oversold market with the 200 EMA, you can play this as the red Bollinger Band, right? As you can see, we got this, it's oversold, overbought, and it came back down, same confirmations. But let me actually find one that's, you know what I'm saying, that correlates with what we're doing right now. Give me one moment. So matter of fact, I think Sam just asked a question about a week. So most definitely. So family, if you can see right here, we have price buying up a, you know what I'm saying, a collective of bullish candles. And we actually had price actually pierce this red bullet, pierce this red Bollinger Band, and it rejected. Okay, cool. That's one half of the confirmation. Now let me go get my selling confirmation real quick. I'm gonna get my confirmations. Now look, a bullish candle must hit the red Bollinger Band, must be rejecting off Bollinger Band, opposite candle must open up. Cool. So let's actually zoom in a little bit right here. I don't wanna do that. I knew that was gonna happen. Hopefully I didn't lose where I was at. Okay, so we was right here. Honestly, there's one right here as well, but so. So check this out. See where price pierced? So what we're gonna do is put a horizontal line. Horizontal line, cool. Bullish candle, and we got the opposite candle that opened up. Boom. That's one, that's confirmation number one. Now, what's the second confirmation? The volume bar has to be red. Now, if we move this over, this volume bar is red, right? Cool. And it should be a straight line all the way down. All of the indicators should match up, right? So this one is red, so now we can move on to the third one, right? We can really move on to the fourth and third because the RSI comes first, right? The RSI has to be overbought and crossing down on the 70. Cool. Let's look. This is the 70. This is the 30. Anything that is overbought is anything above 70, right? And price has to be crossing down on the 70. Confirmation. This is the stochastic, right? Anything above the 80 is overbought. And it must be crossing down on the 80. Now we go look at the currency strength meter. Now we're looking for a sell. So that means that the secondary currency should be appreciating over the primary currency. We have GBP, USD. So the US dollar should have more bars than GBP. All right. Now, I'm not gonna lie. A great trade will be a 4 confirmation trade. A excellent trade will be a 5 confirmation trade. Do not take any trades with only 3 confirmations or 2 confirmations or 1 confirmation. All right. Now, if the US dollar was appreciating the Great British Pound, that'd be a 5-point trade. Cool. We go back here. We go back to Liberty. And we enter at the close of this trade, at the close of this candle, right? So let's actually zoom in. Let me get my trend line entered right here. Boom. For a 15-minute trade, we go back to line chart, and boom, we cleared this trade, family. Hey man, drop some fire emojis if this was a pretty good training. Drop some fire emojis if this was a pretty good training. Drop some fire emojis if this was a pretty good training. Hey man, I appreciate everybody that hopped on this call. I will be doing a market structure call tomorrow. So hey, everybody that's on the call right now, I expect you to be on it definitely tomorrow, same time. Now, before I actually end this call, I will drop my Instagram. My Instagram is JoeGold24. Make sure y'all go follow my Instagram and check this out. I'm gonna actually go to my YouTube page right now. Hold on real quick. And I got a lot more sauce on my YouTube channel, right? Got a lot more sauce on my YouTube channel. I have a Cash Trap 2.0 breakdown that got 11K right now. Yeah, so this is actually my YouTube. Please subscribe, please watch, give me some feedback, give me some constructive criticism. And that's pretty much the end of this training. Whenever I get the video back, I will definitely be posting it. On my YouTube channel. Go to my Instagram page to look out to when I'm actually gonna post the video. Show me some love, please go follow me. I appreciate everybody for hopping on this call. Y'all be safe, y'all be blessed.